probably won't tell you that if you belong to a middle-class family, then I've cut your taxes each year that I've been in office. And I've cut taxes for small business owners 17 times.
You get to choose where change will take us. Because the future does not belong to those who gather armies on a field of battle or bury missiles in the ground. The future belongs to young people with an education and the imagination to create.
That is because we believe that the future does not belong to those who would destroy. It belongs to those who would build. We must insist that the future does not belong to fear. That or another. They are the things a rising nation does.
That money doesn't belong to us. It belongs.
And I don't care what party you belong to. We're all Americans and we're all in this together. And the thing that connects all of us, no matter what part of the country we're from, and certainly no matter what party we belong to, is that we know what it means to govern, what it means to make tough choices during tough times, and hopefully to forge some common ground. Ben-Gurion and Meir, Begin and Rabin, these giants of Israel's founding generation now belong to the ages. In Syria, the future must not belong to a dictator who massacres his people. The overwhelming majority of Americans, I don't care what party they belong to, that's what they want. They just want to see some progress.
His words belong to the ages, possessing a power and prophecy unmatched in our times.
And a friend of Russia's, as long as none of us are in inside of Ukraine trying to meddle and intervene, certainly not militarily, with decisions that properly belong to the Ukrainian people. And that's the principle that they were prepared to fight and die for an America they did not yet fully belong to. Anyone who's driven along the Kennedy has seen the silhouettes of steeples jabbing at the sky, steeples as diverse as the houses of worship that they belong to, and the immigrants that built them, and the communities who call those neighborhoods home to this day.
That tells us that we belong to the same vast region.
We speak different languages, born of different races and ethnic groups, belong to different religions. For a century, rangers and interpreters and volunteers and visitors have kept alive what the writer Wallace Stegner once called the best idea we ever had. Our belief that the country's most special places should belong not just to the rich, not just to the powerful, but belong to everybody. Not just now, but for all time. It reminds us that the history of America doesn't belong to one group or another. It belongs to all of us. That idea, this experiment built on a shared story of people bound together by shared ideas, shared ideals, certain inalienable rights of equality and justice and liberty for all people. Thanks to the ADA, the places that comprise our shared American life, schools, workplaces, movie theaters, courthouses, buses, baseball stadiums, national parks, they truly belong to everyone.
So my question for you is that because Sơn Đoòng is not just belong to Vietnam, it is a world heritage. How would you, an American leader, a global citizen, preserve it? And you also mentioned that you would like to get back to Vietnam. If you have a chance.
Because the parks belong to all of us.
I speak to you, for children belong to no creed. And if holiness exists, it is the selflessness that runs in their veins.